Hello, I'm Graham and I hope everyone's having a great day and welcome to today's video. Now in today's video I'm going to show you how to get accurate exposures in situations which will normally fool the camera. For example, if you're a new user to digital photography and you've bought yourself a bridge camera, you'll probably be shooting in the IA or the IA Plus mode and getting some fairly decent images until you go into situations which fool the camera. Those could be beach scenes, snow scenes, any situation like, hey, I've got a polar bear on snow, I've got some black pens on a black background. Now, they will totally fool the camera and you'll get overexposure in the case of the pen, so the black background will appear grey. And if you're shooting something on snow, again, the snow will appear grey as it's underexposed. So we have some in-camera tools which allows us to get proper exposure. And I'm going to demonstrate those facilities today. Now, to shoot the images today, I'm going to be using the Panasonic Lumix FZ80 or 82, one of the basic bridge cameras from Panasonic. So we'll be able to take some good pictures with the FZ82. Small 1/2-13 sensor, so it's got limited dynamic range, but we should be able to take pictures like the white pen and the black pen on black card and still get some decent results. I'm going to show you how we can achieve that. Now, I'm talking about using an in-camera tool called a histogram. Now, a histogram is just a fancy name for a device which shows us the range of brightness and darkness in a subject. So this is basically a graph which goes from darks on the left-hand side, which is zero value, to whites on the right-hand side, which has got a value of 255. Now the histogram shows the whole range of pixels that are in the image. And if you look at an image and you take it down to pixel level, you see that it's built up of maybe 12 megapixels, 16 megapixels, 22 megapixels, depending on your camera, just how many pixels there are in the image. So what the histogram does is take the value of each one of those pixels and stacks it. So if you've got a whole range of white images like you might have on snow, you'll see a peak towards the 255 end of the spectrum. If you've got a range of blacks like we're going to have with this card, you'll find the peak is towards the zero end or the shadow end. It's a case of really just understanding what you're shooting and what to expect in the histogram. Now, it's worth just refreshing your memories on how exposure works by using the exposure meter in the camera. We can either use the whole area, we can use a center weighted, or we can use the precise spot metering. Whole area takes into consideration everything in the scene and tries to work out whether you're backlit, frontlit, or what type of subject you've got to try and give you the correct exposure. Center weighted assumes that you've got the main subject in the middle of the picture and will bias the exposure for that. If using spot metering, it uses a precise number of pixels to give you a very precise reading of your exposure. What I'm going to do today is show you how we can use the histogram and basically how it works, how to interpret it. What I'm going to do is set up the camera so we can actually see the histogram on the back of the FZ80, and I'll show you as we go along. To help me, I'm going to be using what's called a grey card. Now, these grey cards are fairly cheap and inexpensive, probably £5 or £10 for a good one. It's got an 18% reflectance and it's used for white balancing, but because it's got a 12% illuminance factor, we can actually use this for determining exposure. And if we take a picture of a grey card with the camera set to give us zero on the meter, this should give us a value of 50% of the brightness, or it should give a digital value if we look at it in Photoshop of something like 127 red, 127 green and 127 blue. And I'll show you that as we process it. But more importantly, if we look at this in the histogram, the grey peak will be exactly in the centre of the histogram, which shows us we've got the camera exposure right. If you find the peak is off to one side and you've got the meter set to zero, it means that your camera sensitivity or the aperture or the shutter speed may not be quite correct. So it's a good way of calibrating your camera. If you're finding that you're not getting an accurate exposure with the grey card set exactly to the 127 mark, you probably know your camera's calibration is slightly out. The other way, of course, is to use a handheld light meter, but you're going to be paying £100 for the very basic ones or £250 for a decent one. But there's no need for that. Use your grey card in these situations which are abnormal exposure conditions. So when we're shooting the black pens or we're shooting the white polar bear on a white background, we'll be able to get an accurate exposure just by looking at what the mid-tones will be using a grey card. What I want to do is set up a set of three grey cards. One is black, One is mid-grey and the other is white. And if you look at the histogram, we can see we've got a white peak, we've got the grey peak on 127, and we've got the white peak at 255. So you can see the range of exposures. And you notice those peaks are around about the same height. What I want to do then is to have a black card, and you'll notice all the peaks are towards the left-hand side, so down towards the zero end. I'll now just introduce a small amount of white onto that black card, and you notice we get a very small white peak on the right-hand side, which shows us that's the white end, or the highlights, at 255. So the height of those bars indicates the number of pixels. So in the case of a black card, we'll find most of our bars are down the shadow end. We'll have a very, very small peak at the right-hand side because it's got fewer white pixels in the scene. When people say you want to have a balanced histogram, that's absolutely nonsense. There are very few pictures which will have a totally balanced histogram. And it's a case of reading what you've got in the scene versus what you're seeing on the histogram as to giving you an idea of what type of picture you're actually taking. So don't look for a completely balanced histogram. If we're going to be shooting this white polar bear on a white background, we expect all those peaks to be over towards the highlight side. We don't expect to see peaks around the middle or the black end, the shadow end. If we're finding our peaks are in the middle, it means we're underexposing. And similarly, if we're shooting a black card with black pens on it, if we're finding our peaks are towards the middle, which are the mid-tones, we're fine, we are overexposing and we should be backing off the exposure. Enough of the rambles, let's set the camera up and I'll demonstrate these in practice and show you how to use a histogram to get the best results. So you can see I've now set up the FZ80 on a tripod. And the target is a neutral grey card manufactured by a company called Manon. You get an A4 size and a 5x8 reasonable size cards. Very good quality, a matte finish so you don't get any reflections from light, so they keep the neutrality. Can be used for white balance and exposure determination. So the first thing I'm going to do with this card is actually do a white balance set, as I've just changed studio lighting in here and we need to do a white balance check. So with the FZ80, using the white balance key, go across to the right, select one of the presets, so we'll use number one, and then up key to select the target, make sure that that target is covered by your neutral grey card, and then just menu set to complete the operation. So now we've got the white balance set. Now I'm going to take an exposure on this card to make sure that the camera is seeing the neutral grey as the neutral grey point, and which it goes 127, 127, 127 if we looked at that image in Photoshop or a similar program. Notice we've got an exposure which is the same, we're minus a third of an EV from accurate. So we're in the manual exposure mode. I've got an exposure of aperture 5 and a tenth of a second shutter speed. So I'm just going to change the shutter speed until that shows 0. And now we've got the exposure set to correct position. I'm going to take a shot and we'll have a look at that in the replay mode, and you can see that the histogram is showing that everything is sitting exactly right on that mid axis, which is neutral grey of 127, 127, 127. So our shot is exactly right. What I want to do now is to look at three cards, which will be white, neutral grey and black, and we can have a look at how the histogram records those. So I've set up my three test targets. We've got the black card, the neutral grey card and a white card. And if you notice, I've got more grey card than I have black and white. And there's a reason for that I want to show you in this video. So I'm going to take a exposure of that particular setup. The lighting hasn't changed, so the shutter speed and aperture and ISO can stay the same. So let's just take a shot. If we look at that in the replay mode, you can see we've got three distinct peaks. We've got a peak here which is in the dark area, so that's the black card. We've got a peak here which is in the mid-grey card, and then we've got a peak here which is the white. Now if you notice the heights of these bars, notice the whites are not quite as high as the greys and not quite as high as the black. So it's saying within this image, the number of pixels which are in the white region aren't as many as in the neutral greys or as in the black. So the whole histogram shows you the total number of pixels recorded by the sensor, and the height of these bars shows you the actual number of pixels recorded for each of the colors. So in this case, there's less white, more grey, and slightly less blacks, and that's represented by the histogram values. Now again, without changing the exposure, as lighting hasn't changed, I'm going to take a shot of this grey card. Now you notice the exposure meter on the camera saying that this is not the correct exposure, but we know it is because we've measured this on the neutral grey card. So I'm just going to take that shot. And again, if we look at this in the replay mode, you can see that the peaks are exactly on the blacks of the histogram. So we're showing we've got luminance, blue, green and red, all sitting around where the blacks should be. What I want to do now is introduce the small piece of white paper into the scene, and we'll have a look where the white peak becomes and just how many pixels are denoted by it. So again, we'll take a shot of that. The exposure hasn't changed. And now let's look at that in the replay mode. If you notice in the shot now, we've got the illuminance, the blue, the green and the red all sitting in the black region, but we've got a small peak here which represents this white target. The number of pixels represents the ratio of the whites in this particular shot to the whole scene. So there's very little white in terms of area compared to the area of black, and that's why the height of these bars is relatively small. So you can tell from this scene that the number of white pixels are particularly low. And if you get specular reflections on an object which is causing your highlight blowout, you may not even see these on the bar graph, but they may be right over onto the right hand side of the axis and very, very low in amplitude, so you're not likely to see the blowouts in the histogram. And if you turn on the blinkers, you will see them. So I've now changed over to those pens on the black background. Again, I'm not changing the exposure, as we've set that up on that neutral grey card, so it's still that 1/8 of a second at f5, ISO 80. So I'm going to take that shot. I'll use the self-timer so we can get a nice clear image. And if we notice in the histogram, just put that back into replay mode, we can see we've got a numerous number of peaks here in the black region, and they represent the black background and the shades of black in the image. We've got some smaller peaks here which represent different shades, but you notice we've got a peak here on the right hand side which is representative of the white and the specular reflections coming from this pen on the right hand side. Now, one thing to bear in mind is that this histogram is derived from the JPEG file that the camera's produced. It isn't the actual RAW format that the camera's recorded. If you're shooting in JPEG plus RAW, if you imported this image into your editing program, you'll notice there's quite a bit of space to the left-hand side, which means we're not totally black, and there's a space on the right-hand side, which means we've not gone past the highlights. So now you can notice the blinkies on this image coming from the specular reflections of the lighting on that pen. To be expected with a small sensor camera, as we don't have the full dynamic range that we do with larger format sensors. So in this instance, I might want to consider just backing off the exposure slightly to get rid of that blinky, but if I process this in RAW, I'm sure I can recover those highlights. So let me just change the exposure from where it is at the moment. We're 1/8 of a second, so I'm going to make the exposure shorter to try and reduce those blinkers. So I'm going to go to 1/10 of a second, which is 1/3 of a stop underexposed. So let's take that shot again. Notice we have now got less of those bars showing on the left hand side and reduced number of blinkers. Let's just reduce it a little bit more. So we'll go to 2/3 of a stop underexposed. And we go into the replay mode. Now there are no blinkies and there are no peaks going over to the right hand side. So you can use the histogram and in conjunction with the blinkies to determine your exposure. Notice we're pushing now the blacks over to the left hand side, and we should be able to recover those blacks in image editing, especially if we're shooting in the RAW mode. So that's black objects on a black background. What about my polar bear on snow? So I'm going to set that up and we'll have a look at that. So you can see I've set up this model polar bear on a piece of polystyrene and against a white background. Because of the inverse square law, the light fall off between the studio lights here in the foreground to background mean that we've got a difference in exposure. I'm just going to calculate what the exposure is. I've got a handheld light meter it's good to turn him on. I'm going to take the exposure here at the bare, and that's a 13th of a second at f5.6. And let's just measure the background to see what the difference is. And that's a 5th of a second at ISO 80 f5.6. So roughly a stop difference between here and the background. Just recalculate the exposure using that neutral grey card, make sure we've not changed. Oh yeah, 1/10 of a second at f5. So we're going to take that shot and have a look at that in the histogram. So we expect most of these bars on the histogram to be towards the right hand side. Let's take the shot. And there they are. They are towards the right hand side. So have a look. We've got no midtones because we don't expect to see midtones. If we are moving these towards the mid-tone areas, it means this exposure is going to be underexposed. And that's typically what you'd see if you were shooting on snow. I've changed over to one of the semi-automatic modes, and we've got the same combination here of F5 ISO 80. And notice the exposure is a 25th of a second, so it's much faster than the correct exposure should be. So this is going to give me a underexposed image by about at least two stops. So let's take that shot and have a look at the histogram. And you can see what it's done is to force the whites towards the mid-grays, and that's the whole purpose of the exposure meter. It thinks that everything in the world is a neutral grey and tries to drive them towards that neutral grey position. So that's given me a totally underexposed image. If you're using this manually, then with that combination again of F5, we would use exposure value compensation, and it's going to be the order of one complete f-stop, and that's brought us back to a 13th of a second. So if we take that now, we should see our peaks are moving towards the whites again. So that is how you would correct your exposure in a semi-automatic mode to give you the correct exposure based on that histogram setting. If I was to shoot this color checker test chart now, you notice we've got a range of exposures on the top here from white to black, so they represent the scales of grey, but then we got colour swatches underneath. And if we look at those in the histogram, they will all show different heights dependent on the illuminance of each of those colours. So here we've got white, the third square along is neutral grey, so I'm going to change the exposure metering mode to spot metering, and we'll change its position so it picks up the exposure from that particular area. And if I just move the camera across so that it's in the middle of that square, we'll capture that exposure. And you can see we've got rather a busy histogram now. So the main thing to look for is the fact that the mid-grey should be in the mid-grey areas, the whites should be over onto the right-hand side, and the blacks will be over on the left-hand side. So that's how the histogram would look if you're shooting a multicoloured picture. It will show you the luminance of each of those colours on the test target. So there's how to use the grey card and the camera histogram to give you an idea that you're getting correct exposures with everything you take. I hope you found that useful. If you're a new viewer, of course, and you like what you see, do click me the subscribe button and the bell notification icon, and you'll be advised when I upload new videos to the channel. Also check out my photographic blog, I'll put a link to that in the video description below. You'll find lots more information on photography in general, and in particular the Panasonic Lumix bridge cameras and the EOS M series of cameras. So please do check that out if you've not already done so. So, as usual, thanks very much for watching, please do take care, and I hope to see you all in my next video. Goodbye for now.